Good afternoon from a very familiar setting. It's race day here in Spain, and with everything still to play for in the championship battle, there's no room for mistakes in a Grand Prix that's well known for creating them. It's a sellout crowd of 140,000 here today as we await lights out for the 730-metre sprint down to turn one of this 2.9-mile racetrack. Overtaking is challenging through these 16 corners, but there's still a lot of high-speed excitement to be found, including the flat-out turn three and the terrifying blind right of turn nine. Anthony Davidson is here with me today. Together, we'll be taking you through all the action of this Spanish Grand Prix. It can be hard for the cars to follow each other closely here due to the dirty air coming off the car in front. So perhaps we're looking at a more strategic Grand Prix, Ant. What do you think on that?
I'm not too sure about that, Crofty. I mean, yes, as you say, it's hard to follow around here. But if you're brave on the brakes, you can get the job done down into turn one, which is a medium speed corner, so you have to be committed. And looking down at this grid today, I think we're going to see one or two drivers making a move from a long way back. Maybe try to force their opponent into a mistake. I don't think this is a race that's going to be purely decided in the pit stops.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And it's Felipe Massa alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Rosberg, Vettel, Lewis Hamilton, and Ricciardo, Kvyat, Alonso, Bottas, and Jenson Button, Grosjean, Sainz, Esteban Gutierrez, and Perez, Hülkenberg, Wehrlein, Julian Palmer, and Rio Harianto, Magnussen, and Nasser, Marcus Ericsson, and Kimi Räikkönen rounds off the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
faster in Sector 2 than the car ahead. Sector 2. is in the pits.
Thank you.
best lap of the race so far.
Thank you.
tyres should remain dry. We will keep you informed of any changes to the weather. 3.7 seconds. So the gap to our teammate is 0.8 seconds. Seconds. Let's try and get past in the DRS zone. again, the safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car, in this lap. Hamilton's just moved into first place. Yes. conditions should remain dry. We will keep you informed of any changes to the weather. 10 seconds. distance to the leader is 8.8 seconds. that's just taken first place. job. You did really well. Super driving.
Brilliant stuff from Mercedes today. That's another historic win. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Without a doubt, the safety car changed everything today. The key to their success was keeping calm and reacting to the situation quickly. We've seen teams in the past throw away wins because they were too hesitant, but here they were decisive, and that's allowed them to take the advantage.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It's a good result for Nico Rosberg, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I think it's got to be Kimi Räikkönen. He's not always spectacular, but he quietly gets the job done. And that's the case today.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time.